guys know what time it is.
It's podcast time. Yeah.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
Hey.
And it's funny because the guy that does podcasts isn't even here.
Yeah, I was about to say. Where's he at?
He's outside on the phone.
Got a phone call.
Who's he talking to?
Some guy named Barry.
We don't know that.
Barry?
I thought, no, when did he went out, he was like, hey, Barry.
Oh, he did say that.
Yeah.
Who's Barry?
I don't know.
He's probably still doing work on the side. Remember how when we were starting this business, he was always doing work on the side?
Yeah. Construction of sorts. Uh-huh.
Like everyone had finally quit their day jobs, but Simon's still like, oh, I got a flooring job.
Yeah,
it's taking months.
Suck me back in.
He was miserable doing that too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He would always come in mad about something.
So this is going to surprise him. This is...
Yeah, maybe Barry is... He's got his own YouTube channel, and he's branching off.
Yeah. He's been wanting to open toys his whole life.
Yeah.
Now
Simon loves that.
Barry could be involved with the new car Simon got.
Oh, he did get a new car.
Yeah, Simon finally got rid of the, that thing.
That thing
Ford
was...
Explorer that was held together by hope and, like, bird shit.
It was the equivalent of, like, that old pair of shoes you hang on to. It's got holes and it's all...
I had those.
Right.
Well, you had flip-flops like that, too.
Oh, yeah. No, I wear everything on my feet until they turn to powder.
I fixed my shoes, though. It was in a video.
Yeah.
I put the rubber stuff on the bottom.
Congratulations on that, by the way.
And I've stapled a hat together before.
Nothing wrong with a staple and a hat.
Until...
And you made a hat out of old flip-flops.
Until it was cutting me.
Oh.
Oh, no.
And then, like, go to kiss my girl if I had that hat on.
You're fucking bleeding.
Like, yeah, slit her
eye.
Forehead
oh,
open.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Is that why you had stitches?
They do that in Pinky Blinders, don't they?
Yeah.
Pinky Blinders.
Yeah, they
put staples on the back.
Razor blades into the back of their derby.
Mm-hmm.
And then they pull it off their head and slice people
there.
Out.
Oh, damn.
I fastened a whole group of papers together.
Yep. Pretty convenient. Don't do it,
that sounds
guys.
Nasty.
When you think Simon will be back?
I don't know. He'll be in here in a minute.
I was giving him a little bit of shit about his car.
Yeah, you were giving a lot of shit. He got a good deal.
Which is crazy. It's a good-looking car.
It is a good-looking car.
It's a Saab.
It's a Saab.
Here's the thing.
Who cares?
I know the backstory.
It's a car.
Okay?
He knows a guy that's a mechanic in town, and apparently this guy has a bunch of Saabs at his disposal. So he's like, hey, I can sell you this car. It's a good deal, and if it breaks, I've got all the parts right here. I can pretty much guarantee.
Right around the corner.
I can guarantee this car's going to keep running. Because it's easy. Apparently, it's really easy to switch the motors
like
on these things.
Yeah, four bolts or something, and you can drop the engine out.
Well, it's got a Lego engine. That's why.
Who cares?
Doesn't matter.
It has four wheels, and it gets you from point A to point B. It's all a car needs to do.
You're really adamant about not giving it. I mean, I'm with you.
Don't give a shit about a car. Like, I was never one of those guys that's just like, oh, that car's got to look fancy. You know, you see these guys that dress their car all up. I'm like, what are you doing? Look at all the money you're fucking pissing down the drain on this piece of shit.
People do spend too much on cars.
When I was in Australia, I didn't have a car for most of the time, so I had to borrow one.
You rode a kangaroo.
My girlfriend at the time, her sister had a car, and if I ever really needed one, she let me borrow it, and it was pretty funny.
Bang her sister.
Because I had a buddy, he and I just did labor work everywhere.
Yeah.
But here we are riding around this car that was like this little bubble looking silver thing with the cow print steering wheel and like fairies hanging from the mirror.
Yes.
We didn't even care.
No, he probably looked awesome.
Oh, we look good.
Yeah.
Simon would have got that car if he had the chance.
Hey, we should get Simon a cow print steering wheel cover.
Yeah, we should.
And a seat cover too. A dream catcher.
Hey, yeah, get him a dream catcher.
We should get him something nice for his new car.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah.
Get him a license plate thing to go around it.
Ooh, we can get those eyelashes he can put on his headlights.
Yes.
Yeah.
We got to do
that. Eyelashes.
And get him some balls. truck nuts.
Saab nuts.
Saab nuts.
Except we could get him the testicular cancer version that just one.
Oh, God.
You know,
there's just one of them?
Well, it's probably cheaper.
Probably.
Or there's two of them, but one of them looks really fucked up.
Has there ever been a case of someone having three testicles?
I don't know.
We should bing that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should
bing
that.
You need bing to bing
that.
Yeah,
use the bing.
I would imagine.
Okay, Neves is getting out his phone right now, and he is going to look at this.
What, 7 billion people on the planet?
Had to have happened.
You're going to find some unsavory websites come up for that.
Yes, you are.
Polyorchidism. Is the incidence of more than two testicles. It is very rare. The most common form is tritestes, where three testicles are present.
So there you go.
Are you lucky or not lucky?
I don't know. That's a lot of sperm.
Interesting.
It is interesting.
The things you learn here.
The human body.
Welcome to science, folks.
I did get a good science fact on NPR the other day.
Eh?
They discovered the real reason that birds that fly in a flock, like the V... That one side's longer than the other.
Real reason?
Huh?
Oh, why one side's longer than the other?
Yeah.
Is that because there's not enough birds to even it out?
Yeah, there's more birds on that side.
Wow.
Yep.
That study cost $250,000 yes, of our taxpayer money.
Yeah. I should be a scientist.
Fuck you.
I just winged it on that one.
I'm a scientist.
It was really good.
Some asshole sitting out in a field for years just watching birds like, huh.
That's it.
Yeah. I think I got this nailed down finally.
Drives away in a Bentley.
Four fuck all on that side and five on the other.
Huh. Can't wait to publish this.
Yeah.
This paper's going to blow it up.
We should publish a science paper.
Yeah, we should.
That'd make us more valuable, I think.
I don't think.
Oh, look who's here.
Hey! Simon's back.
Do you want to participate in your podcast?
Well, it's not my podcast. It's our podcast.
You're in charge of it.
You run the show.
You're the showrunner.
That's a big deal.
Well, it's good that you came back in because we're about to wrap things up.
Yep. Okay. Well, listen, you can download this.
We're not, not just yet. We're going to talk another minute or two.
Yeah, we got some time. Just another minute.
Yeah. I wasn't sure. Okay. I didn't know. You said
we covered all the important things, though.
We talked about your car a little bit.
Oh.
Yep.
How you liking it?
Trying to figure out who Barry is.
Dude, I just got off the phone with the guy who sold me the car.
Who's Barry?
Oh, so
Simon?
Barry's the guy that sold you the car.
Yeah.
Did he need it back?
Oh, no. I.
Are you happy right now with Barry?
He is. If you think I'm emotionally unstable, woo.
Did he call you with problems? Like life problems?
No, it's funny. It's like I had an issue with my headlights. I said, they're pointed down a little bit. And he's like, listen, they're older. You might need to get new ones.
They're sagging.
Like, I don't know, man. I don't know if I want to talk about this right now.
No, you do.
Oh, yeah.
I want to hear about your headlights. We were going to get you some eyelashes for it.
So. Yeah,
we want to make sure those things are bright and they look good.
I was hoping that would be a surprise for him.
Yeah.
Oh, that would have been nice.
Well, is that your biggest problem with the car is the headlights?
Oh, no. Listen, I'm fine. I'm thrilled with
it. You have to have the headlights on to be able to start it, too.
Well, the headlights actually have to be straight to pass inspection.
Right.
That can't be a hard fix.
No, it's not.
Aiming your lights?
Not a big deal. I just want a car to get from point A to point B, and right now I have one, and I'm happy.
Next time you talk to him, we'd love to hear it.
Perfect.
Can you get in on your driver's side now?
I can get in all four doors.
Yeah?
Oh, my God.
Who's living large?
Air conditioning, heat, radio.
Does
all
that have a tape deck?
CD.
Holy shit.
Do you feel like people look at you differently when you're driving now? Like people judge you differently?
Do you wear a monocle when you drive?
Yeah. Do you feel obligated to dress differently?
A top hat?
Listen, it's a nice car to me, but I tell you one thing. Like, Vic, you seem very judgmental today.
Wow. He's got something against sobs. It's weird.
Look at that. He's a gay man over there.
So what made you buy a Saab?
He got raped by a Saab when he was a child.
Yeah.
No, we talked about it earlier.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, what was it?
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. You gotta realize.
You'll have to download the podcast.
Most of us were against it.
Damn it.
After you cut it.
All right.
Thick doesn't know what it's like to be tall, so there's a whole different set of rules that apply there.
Actually, that's a small car low to the ground. That'd be good for you.
Okay, good.
Is that why you get big vehicles, Thick?
I don't get big vehicles. I got a medium size. Like, my Jeep Cherokee's not big. It's not.
Well, like, your bumper sticker that says, I'm a man, is a little overboard.
Well, honk if you're a man.
Yeah, honk if you're a man. Beep, beep. That'd be a great bumper sticker, yeah?
Oh, we should make those.
We should make those.
Honk if you're a man.
We need to start making bumper
stickers. Yeah, I'm a
Mario.
Do any of our shops offer bumper stickers?
I know we have stickers on the Design by Humans, but I don't know if they're bumper stickers exactly. I'll see if we can make them.
That'd be, yeah. I feel like we could come
there
up with some.
There should be a run of honk if you're a man sticker.
Honk if you're a man.
You don't need to be a bumper sticker. Just a sticker you stick right on the
on the bumper.
No, yeah.
Or the window.
But you can't put that on your notebook. No one's got a horn with them.
No, I'm just saying your car.
Yeah.
Putting a sticker on a notebook's kind of a waste of a sticker, huh?
It really is.
Not if it doesn't say honk on it.
You know what I used to love when I was a kid? Do you guys ever go to South of the Border when you were a kid?
Yes.
Oh, don't get this started.
I think it'd be a great destination.
Okay.
Well, yeah, for a community trip.
Yeah.
But one of the things when I was growing up was we'd go to Florida every year, and they used to, back in the day, give away the bumper stickers. So they were free.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
That's advertising.
Yeah. So that was like, you go back to school and you bring everyone souvenirs and have like 60 like bumper stickers and just handing them out to everybody. I love South of the Border.
Uh-huh. Yep.
Anyway.
Flamin' Amy's does that at the restaurant.
Yeah.
Don't they give out free bumper stickers?
They do. Yeah. My daughter's got one on the back of her ukulele.
There you go.
Your daughter plays the ukulele?
Yeah.
Huh.
My roommate plays the ukulele.
Your roommate's my daughter.
That's a weird situation.
It is. It is. But we kicked her out for being a total bitch.
Yeah.
Oh, but then I got a fan sent me a suggestion for a different meetup. It's like a Jimmy Buffett themed destination.
Okay, so completely out of the question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, no.
Just throwing it out there. Now,
is it Key West?
If it's Key West without Jimmy Buffett, then
yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
I think that's a great idea.
Key West would be wonderful.
If nothing came out of the instruments and Jimmy Buffett's mouth during his concerts, I bet they'd be awesome.
Yeah, you're probably right.
The music actually isn't that bad. It's more like his voice, right?
I can't stand
it. It's everything.
I can't stand it.
I mean, I'm not a fan either.
Whenever I hear his voice, it turns my spine to glass, and then it's like hit with a hammer and just shatters.
Yeah.
So here we go. Stephen Caldwell sent me this. It's the Margaritaville Island Hotel in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. Welcome to Margaritaville Island.
It's a weird place for a Margaritaville.
Tennessee.
In Tennessee.
Yeah.
It doesn't work.
Island?
Yeah.
In Tennessee.
Book your stay now.
No.
That's
no.
like the
Fuck
Kokomo
you.
Restaurant
Fuck
in Indiana.
Yeah. Inspired by the lyrics and lifestyle of singer-songwriter and author Jimmy Buffett, Margaritaville Island Hotel.
You always think of island music and
they just,
shit like that.
Yeah, and they just throw the word singer and songwriter around like it's confetti.
I really like that Mountain Lodge Resort they have in Daytona Beach.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
That is such a weird location.
Strange.
For that
brings a new perspective to the Smoky Mountains experience. They've got mountain luxe
surroundings.
Yep.
Who burped? It smells like shit in here.
That might not have been a burp, but it
that's
wasn't me.
Food, I think.
Oh,
I think Anthony brought in food.
Yeah.
Anthony just
Anthony
came
just
microwaved his,
Flamin'
his lunch.
Has a new burnt turd on their menu.
With burp sauce.
Yeah, burp sauce. Yeah.
Burp up.
Oh, hey, I know what we need to be talking about.
What?
We just went on a trip. We were going to talk about
this. Oh, yeah.
We
yeah.
never talked about
okay.
that?
No. No. We went to freaking Sweden.
Well, I'm
again.
Ready to talk about it.
Oh, yeah.
Because what made me think of it was the burp as I was sitting with next to you on the plane.
Right.
I swear to God, fucking, you must have burped like six or seven
no,
times.
No, obviously you don't know what direction. A burp is because he just cooked food and you're like, who burped? It's not a burp. It's just food.
Well, there was no
apparently
food.
The smell of food to you is a burp.
Well, this but is burp-ish. This has got a burp.
No, it smells like spaghetti.
It
or
came
some sort
up
of
in
pasta.
Conversation. The burp came up.
Okay,
back to the story.
Came up. The burp came up. Anyway, you were burping on the plane, and I smelled it.
No,
I
had
like
food
it.
On the plane.
No, this was when there was
no
food.
You just proved you don't know the difference.
And you know what? And oh man!
And now I question every burp you've ever smelled in your life.
And you know
you
what?
Don't even know how to burp.
Listen, no, I don't. You're right. But you love that airplane food, don't you?
Man, I love that airplane food.
It's so
every
ridiculous.
Meal I got was like 5 stars.
No, not every meal. I heard that
the
you
last
were somewhat,
one was weak.
Yeah, I heard that you were a little bit disappointed on the way back.
That rice chicken curry thing, delicious.
Yes, on the way there,
that was very good. Yeah,
I was on a different flight. I didn't.
They shouldn't tell you though. Hey, you want the chicken and rice? You should say curry in there somewhere. It's like chicken and rice. I'm thinking, oh, it's going to be chicken and rice. Pretty plain dish. Okay, that's going to be simple. I did not like the curry.
Yeah, it'd be good to know if there was curry involved.
But anyway, we went to Sweden and we're talking about the fucking airplane.
Yeah, listen, if that airline had a restaurant here in town, I would eat it every week.
That's insane.
You are sick.
No,
your standards are low.
It was good. I don't understand how you don't realize that.
But we went to the Battlefield premiere party.
Yeah, what a fucking honor.
Yeah.
That was
so
hell of a party.
Cool, man.
Yeah,
that was
awesome.
Like over 1,000 people sit down dinner, and man, I tell you what I really enjoyed was the service staff. They were like so militaristic in how they did it. It was very impressive. I was watching that and appreciating it because they had like little like lieutenants that were kind of like off in little sections and like how they yeah, I guess you had to witness it, but it was impressive to me. To serve that many people and I'm sure everyone's food was warm.
It was in like an airplane hangar or something like
it
that.
It was in an old hangar.
It was very cool.
Yeah,
and who
was
speaking
was
with Nils up on the stage?
Dan.
Thank you.
Dan
Nils. I wanted to say Dave, and I'm like, it's not Dave.
Yeah,
it's
Nils
Dan.
And Dan were the host of the party.
They were
did
great.
Great.
They
did great.
Awesome.
Their suits were fantastic. They both had Pac-Man suits on.
Yep.
I posted a picture of us on my Instagram page, and we got some pretty fun comments about Simon.
Oh, great. Let's talk about that. So, listen, I didn't want to buy
Betty
clothes.
Drives a Saab.
Yeah. I was like, oh, I got a hodgepodge of clothes that are kind of respectable that made me look like
an English teacher. Yeah, you really did.
And yeah, it was bad, and I look bad, and thank
fine.
You.
I no, thought you looked great.
I love the fact that Thick brings this up because he knows it bugs me. And
you
it's
were
okay.
Really self-conscious about it. You could have worn anything.
I know.
You could have worn scuba gear. People would have been fine with it.
I should have.
I got comments too, Simon.
Oh yeah, someone said you look like a waiter.
Yeah, because I didn't want to pack a jacket.
Well,
I carried everything I took with me in one backpack,
and a lot of people made comments about my Converse or Chuck Taylors.
Yep.
I just wanted a little bit of rock and roll in there.
Spice it, flare that shit up.
Yeah, right?
Didn't want to buy thinking he drove a Saab.
Makes me think of an 80s movie.
I drive a truck because I'm a man, and it says, honk if you're a man.
It has truck nuts and a dick on it.
Apsor bought a suit.
I know.
Well, I didn't have one suit that fit, and I figured, like, well,
that was a new
may
suit.
As well.
He
may
went
as well
and
go
stole, no, you went and stole it off a dead guy at a funeral parlor.
I did. It was cheap.
I remember when I brought up, it's like, you know, we should probably dress up, and you were like, oh, fuck that. Yeah. You know, I'm wearing jeans.
Yeah. And that's why I was like, hey, I'm going to look good as a teacher. And I'm like, better than him. Yeah. And then he has a fucking 3-piece suit.
Him looking bad.
Then
he looked sharp when he got there.
Yeah, he looked great.
Well, the thing is, it was like I already had the jacket. I was gonna wear jeans. I honestly didn't care, but when I put my jacket on, I like from where I lost all the weight, it's just too baggy.
Yeah.
So I was like, I don't have a good suit. Fuck it, I'm gonna buy a suit.
Yeah.
That was
fun. That was a very fun party.
Yes, it was.
Well, hell yeah.
Without a doubt.
And it food was good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, everything was good.
What and, I like when we meet people from DICE, one, they're great and they know our work usually.
Yeah.
And they like it. And then two, we've usually hit on a sensitive spot with them at some point in our career. Like one guy will be like, oh, I'm the user interface guy. I'm like, oh, did you see the video we did about it? He's like, yeah, I saw it.
Yeah.
Because we've picked on almost every department in that company.
Yeah.
But they all love it. They think it's great that we're kind of the voice of the community picking on little things. And maybe it even helps them to improve things.
Lars, I was talking to him before we left about that. And he was bringing that up, how much he enjoys the fun poking, you know?
It's good. It's with love.
Yeah.
It is all
that's
love.
That's what makes, I mean, they could be, you know, God, they could have been jerks about it, but I mean, the fact that they're all cool and they're like, yeah, that's, you know, you have to be able to make fun
you
of yourself.
You have to.
We do have to give them a congratulations because while we were there, they won the award for best office in Sweden.
And it's a killer freaking, I see why.
Oh,
it's a
yeah.
killer office.
Yeah.
That place is great.
We played pool.
Yep, played pool.
Ping
we
pong?
Played some
ping pong.
Pong.
And that slidey, what do you call it? The hockey
salt table.
Slidey disc
salt thing. Shuffle game.
Ooh,
no, that was fun.
Super sprint.
Old school. Oh,
Super sprint. Yeah, they had the arcade.
That game was fun, wasn't it?
We should get one of those for the office, huh?
Where we put it. Super sprint.
Anthony's
hole.
Yeah. Everything that doesn't fit in here goes in Anthony's room.
That's it. Yeah. He's got a big room.
Hey, one day we can have an office and we can put a super sprint machine in it.
There we go, huh?
Goals to shoot for.
Goals.
Super sprint machine and one of those Coke freestyle machines.
Oh, perfect.
You can mix every flavor.
Ooh, I'll do that because I can get seltzer water and put a little cherry
flavor
in.
Yeah, seltzer water.
Oh, one of those coffee things that they had that.
No.
They have
chocolate.
All over.
I don't want that anywhere because I would want to get it every day.
Yep.
Like, oh, hot chocolate.
That'd be the point.
And the cocaine machine they had.
Oh, that was good.
Spits it out on the table.
Just in perfect lines.
Here's your nose candy, sir.
But it gets, what does it get? Got dark there around 3.
30.
This time of year?
Yeah.
There was not much daylight.
I think the high was 35 degrees.
But it was colder before we got there, and it snowed before we got there, so we got pretty lucky.
It was still wet, though. It was rainy.
I must have heard you, Neeb, say, man, I would not live here. In hell. Yeah.
I would live there in the summer.
Such a baby.
I'd have a
Look, I didn't mind the temperature while we were there. In my mind, I was like, I'm leaving in a little bit. Not a big deal.
Yeah.
Like today's beautiful. You can't go outside and go, oh, I don't need this. I'm fine with it being cold and wet.
How would you be in the tropics?
Happy every day.
It's too hot.
Nope.
Oh, no.
I get in the water.
Yeah.
Yeah, didn't jump in the pool.
Huh. Do you know that tropics, I was reminded on that Planet Earth series, which is so badass. They're making another one.
Oh, yeah.
The tropics is 3-4% of the Earth, but has 50% of all animal life and plant life.
Things that are alive need to be in that kind of environment. We are living things.
Yeah.
That's where we belong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I got something I want to talk about.
What you got?
Simon had, what was it, 20 euro?
10.
10 euro.
10 euro.
Yeah, 10 euro that he got like a long time ago when we went to London for the Battlefield launch.
Right.
Or I guess they were announcing it was going to be about World War I.
I had it tucked in my passport. I'm like, oh, I'll be able to spend this at some point.
So you've had that ever since then, I guess.
Yep.
And
that's like 12 bucks.
So we go to Sweden. Sweden has their own money.
Yeah, but
they don't do euros.
Kronos.
They do euros in some places.
You keep saying that, and it's not true.
I heard that rumor.
Thank you.
Well, listen, I heard you try to get rid of this $10 euro 100 times this week.
You did.
The first time we're at the bar at that night.
Let's translate 100.
You guys take euros, right? And she's like, no, we use Kronos here. And you're like, yeah, but some places. She's like, nope. Nothing I've ever heard of.
Never happened ever.
And then Simon's like, okay, well, this waitress that lives here has no idea how this country works.
Right.
I'll try this at the next place. And every place is like, no, we don't use that money here.
So there was a 7-Eleven down the block from the hotel that took it.
They took it? Do they have two different registers?
Not this trip.
How do they deal with that?
Not this trip, though.
Oh.
That one near the Reval?
Yeah.
Yes.
And I'm not even sure about that.
I want to say I remember spending some euros there.
Yes.
So yeah, I think I'm with you.
There you go. Now shut up.
Simon was finally able to spend his 10 euro on this trip, but it was at the airport.
That's right.
There you go. Hey, so congratulations. So
they brought this up.
It's funny because every vendor we came across, you're like, you take these, right?
Yeah.
No.
Because I just wanted to get rid of it. Yeah.
We don't have euros.
Just because we shouldn't forget to bring this up, the hotel, that first night. You remember what club
was
it?
I remember,
The American Swedish Club.
It was the America Club.
The America Club in Sweden.
We got little green stickers.
Gave us discounts.
We became honorary members within a minute.
Yeah.
Just for walking in the door.
We were pretty qualified for that.
Yeah, it was all people in Stockholm that love America, maybe either lived in America or just...
Have ties to America, maybe.
Have ties to America.
Yeah. But, and then there was the speech.
With the rave music playing
behind it.
Yeah. And then once the speech was done, they cut the music off.
He was like the Swedish ambassador to the U.S. or something like that.
But we got a discount on our drinks.
We sure done
did. Nice. All right.
So Sweden, good food, good people, good times.
Wet eggs.
Shitty weather.
Very wet eggs.
Wet. At the hotel?
Yeah.
Well, that's a hotel thing.
Well, hotels that's a European
generally
thing.
Have the powdered eggs.
I've eaten more hotel eggs than anybody here. Probably 10 lifetimes of
Are
hotel
Are you bragging
eggs.
About that?
I'm just telling you. I know what I'm talking about here.
Right.
I used to work in hotels.
Yeah.
Powdered eggs every day.
But they add an overwhelming amount of either cream or milk.
Yeah,
or
they were
just
runny.
Plain water.
But that's very common in
hotels.
It's
like a soup. It's an egg soup.
Yeah.
Now, the eggs we had in London were fantastic.
Delicious.
I think the British folks, they do eggs better than anybody.
Do a good egg.
What do you think?
Well,
Leaves?
I think you ate at one place in London. I think you got to eat it more to make that decision.
Well, no, I had eggs at the one place, and they were the best eggs I've ever had.
Look, I didn't just see one V formation of geese and go, they're all odd numbers of birds.
I watched Gordon Ramsay. He did a video on how to make scrambled eggs, the British style. And it was an interesting technique how you put it on the heat, you take it off the heat, put it back on, take it off, and it kind of makes that consistency like we had in London.
Also, you can add that powder. You know, you do the magic trick in the cup with the water.
What?
You're like, oh, look, I got a cup of water. Nope, it's gelatin.
Have you ever had that?
You add that to your eggs.
Am I the only person you've seen that's had that? Or have
that
you
trick?
Seen it? Yeah. I bought a little thing of that up at a magic shop in the Mall of America once.
Okay, well, that's a spoiler. Never mind. I don't want to spoil magic for
you. Well, no, let's spoil it. It's like this powder you buy, and just like a tiny pinch, if you throw it into any liquid within...
Or hotel eggs
within, I don't know, 15 seconds, it turns completely to gel.
And then you throw the cup at someone. Like, oh my God, I thought there was water in there.
It'll do it to a beer, but turns out that pisses people off.
So next time my kid's in the bathtub,
yeah.
If I take this stuff and throw it in there, it's just going to create a gelatin around there? Fuck yeah, all right, I'm going to try that.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Awesome.
You might need a teaspoon or a tablespoon.
To get her out?
Of the powder.
Yeah,
of the powder.
A lot of
powder.
Okay, so I need a lot of powder. Okay, well, that's fine. I can manage that.
That stuff's crazy.
Magic. I love... Okay, I didn't watch any of it like this year, but I like America's Got Talent. I like all the talents. Like, they're all over the world. Mm-hmm. But the magic shit is probably my favorite shit to watch.
Yeah.
Big time.
We have a very... one of our fans who I got to meet in London when I went out with my lady for my birthday, Siler Bogdan. He's a very successful magician.
Really?
There. Yeah, and he's fantastic. He did tricks at our meetup. Great dude and very good magician. So
nice.
Yeah, if anyone, you find him on Facebook and he's got YouTube videos and stuff. He's
man.
Great.
I had a roommate that hated magic. She always felt deceived and she thought they were liars, and just had this real passionate hate for magicians.
Like you with Sobs?
Worse.
You see a good magician, you just appreciate it. I don't know.
We were at the Hard Rock and there was a magician there and she was like, I don't want that motherfucker coming near me.
Well, listen, I'm not a big fan of table magic.
Uh-huh.
I am.
I'm here to watch a show. I don't want to be eating dinner like, hey, look at me.
Yes.
I'm taking
that is
your
annoying.
Watch.
I agree
I'm
with you
I'm doing this.
That.
Right.
I don't want that.
That happened the last trip that we were
in
on.
Germany.
We were in a bar in Germany.
Yeah.
I thought he was great, but I was also buzzed and in a great mood.
I was at the angle you shouldn't be.
I saw some
saw
things
everything.
That were.
Yeah, I was where I saw everything.
You saw him pulling
fun.
The stuff out of his ass.
That's it. But it was fun. He looked like Charlie Chaplin.
Yeah, he was dressed.
He was dressed in a kind of a creepy way. I think I would have liked a little bit more if he looked normal.
If he was dressed like RuPaul?
Yeah, that would have been great.
He was driving a Saab.
Boy, oh boy.
It's going to go for a while, isn't it?
Apparently.
That's what
it's
just
a nice looking car.
I'm just fucking with you.
I know you are. It's just.
I like that this is now a new thing. Thank you for bringing a new thing to the table.
Yeah.
No problem.
And we have like, nothing.
Down the road, we can honestly we say, Simon, tell us your sob story.
Sob story.
Yes.
Listen, put a honk if you're a man sticker on there.
Yep.
Good to go.
I want to order that shit. We need to make that happen. And by we, I mean you.
Okay.
Simon wants no part of that legwork.
Nothing.
Stickers.
So we've
gone
from burps to sobs to magic to Sweden. God, where do you go from here?
We just quit. Shut it down.
Shut it down. Wrap it up.
Yep. Everybody shut it down. Turn the lights off.
You know what? Here's a... Well, God. I've been working on the last podcast with pet peeves, and I had one that really annoys me.
You're going to do pet peeves again?
It's just something that bothers me.
Okay. Let's hear it.
When you go to get gas, and they're asking you if you want to buy lottery tickets, and they're asking you if you want
to get a fucking car wash. Well, you don't go in to buy gas, do you?
But you swipe the thing.
On the machine.
Oh, they ask you on the machine. Yeah.
I've not seen that.
Play the lottery.
I've never seen a lottery on the
machine. Play the lottery. Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Where do you buy your gas?
Gas stations like Exxon or BP. I mean, those gas stations are pretty basic gas stations, it's and like, they all those
and they're
are the
trying
ones I
to like
to.
Pump a bad habit on you, like
right.
It's not
it's like remember you have this gambling problem. Hey, you want to get your fix?
Yeah,
you know it's
fuck
bullshit.
That.
Well, they also like the ones that are annoying me now are the ones with the displays on them, and they're actually playing fucking television.
Yeah,
commercials.
It's like Mario Lopez here from Entertainment Weekly.
Yeah,
I want to tell you about Taylor Swift.
And I got to listen to some fuckwit try to sell me some shit.
In all fairness, I've had a weather report and caught up on some sports at one point. Sometimes it's not bad. Yes.
Hey, a weather report would be fucking great.
Weather makes perfect sense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Quit trying to sell me tampons.
That's
that's all I ask. Well,
sounds like you need one, you little bitch.
Ooh.
I do.
All right, back to positive things. Sorry, I brought it down.
Do you know what I enjoy?
What?
On even though I don't really care for Facebook, I enjoy those top-down recipes, those real quick ones that people
love
do.
Them.
I would
you
much
do,
rather
you
see
share
those
them.
Than political bullshit or any negativity. If you're posting those on Facebook, keep it up.
They're inspiring.
Yeah, I like watching those.
And the reason why I share them is because of like a reminder to myself, which I don't usually cook, but it's like if I'm gonna cook, those are the things they make it look so easy. A lot of them are very simple.
Yeah.
Have you ever cooked one?
Nope.
But it's coming.
Neither have I, but they make me happy because it's like, ooh, that looks good and easy.
We should make our own top down cooking videos.
Yes, we should.
I think that's actually coming down the road.
Anthony, what did you eat? Okay.
Oh, he got food to go.
Yeah.
He got like a burp.
Burnt turd.
They're right.
Noodles.
If Simon doesn't know the difference between a burp and food, like when you go to a buffet, you should just be disgusted. Like this whole place smells like a giant burp.
Who burped?
Simon's hands just in his face right now. Like, God damn it.
I can smell burps. You're driving me crazy.
You've just proven you can.
You really want to go here?
Well,
because all the times that I've ever said to you, who the fuck just burped? You say me. So almost every time when I do it, you admit to it. So obviously I know what a burp smells like, right?
Nope. Half those times I had food with me.
No.
Yep.
No. You're just making up shit now to get a rise out of it.
Sometimes I keep a fajita quesadilla
in his
on
pocket.
My person.
Well, that actually sounds good.
They are good.
I didn't eat lunch.
If you want to impress your friends, the actual term for burping is eructation.
Eructation.
So why is it that I can't burp? Because I really don't burp.
I don't know, because it releases gas that is built up in your body from swallowing air.
I don't swallow air, apparently.
You swallow air all the time.
Well, I don't.
Especially when you eat or talk quickly, chew gum, or drink through a straw. I don't know how they don't come out of you. Do they come out your ass?
Oh, I fart all the time.
Well, there you go.
Most people burp between 6 and 20 times a day.
That's crazy. I'll burp like 6 times. I do burp, but it's literally the... and it's always a surprise.
In some cultures, a burp after a meal is considered to be a compliment to the chef.
I like that. We need to adopt that here in America.
India happens to be one of them.
Yeah,
I wish I could. They look like they feel good.
Oh, they do.
It sounds dangerous what you got going on over there. Like, if you drink a Coke, you could die,
it
seems
like.
You're
just going to pop one day.
I just combust. No, I fart a lot.
You know, my youngest daughter, she says something whenever she burps at the dinner table. She's like, oh, that means the tank's full. I'm like, where the fuck did you learn that, you little fucker? Like, did you tell her that, Abstro?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, it sounds like something you would say, but she always says that and then tries to get out of eating. If she could take two bites and be like and let out a burp and be like, oh, tank's full, I'm gonna go play.
What?
You get your ice cream here.
No, you sit down and watch us all finish.
Oh my god, man.
Yeah, I hate
getting
that
her
shit.
To eat is like
And you know what? It's already almost too late. How old?
I don't know.
You need to implement that shit early. Mm-hmm. Vegetables need to happen early.
I was very, very picky as a kid.
So was I.
Yeah. I was too.
And I grew into, at some point, I went from really picky to, what is that, pickled tongue? Sure, I'll try it.
I also think when you're kids, your taste buds are a whole lot more sensitive.
Yeah, they're very different.
So
yeah.
Everything is either more bitter. Like,
but the thing, I think most parents are such pushovers in that department.
Yes.
Like if it's there, that's what your option is. I'm not going to make you chicken nuggets because you don't like this.
Exactly.
But
that's
a lot of people
I
do
mean,
that.
I remember as a kid being forced to eat a vegetable soup.
Yeah.
And my gag reflexes were going.
Oh, that's...
It wasn't like I was being picky.
Right.
This was going to make me throw up.
Well, maybe it was just a horrible
soup. Pork and beans did that for me.
Like, why not just have a vegetable, like broccoli?
But the thing is, if kids' taste buds are a lot more sensitive than an adult, mm-hmm. I think they need to eat healthy. But you go, okay, my kid can eat plain chicken and green beans. If that needs to be every single meal, I think that's fine. Don't like, here, have this chicken curry one day.
You still want to have them trying different things all the time. Listen, you don't have to eat all of this, but
it.
You need to try this.
Yeah, of course.
Try this and try that. When I was a kid, the worst thing you could ever give me was London broil. My mom would make London broil. She didn't realize that it was, first of all, it was a good thing to have red in there. She was always a well done, which,
oh God,
which
you
is
were just
fucking ridiculous.
Chewing on a leather boot.
Yeah, but I couldn't swallow it unless I had like these tiny little pieces. So I would just chew, make it look like that I was eating it. Then I'd spit it out into the napkin and then do it until most of it was gone. And then I'd take the napkin, go into the bathroom and flush it down the toilet.
That's where that started.
That's where it started.
That's when you first started flushing meat.
But I chewed that meat, you know?
Okay.
But it's true. Yeah.
You didn't chew up the beef stick you tried to flush a few months ago.
Right. I didn't realize that's where it came from.
It was
you're
an 18-inch beef stick you tried to flush.
18 inches or 6 inches, but whichever.
Let's go with 18.
Okay. It sounds better.
Let me ask you guys this. What is a food that you hated as a kid that you like now?
So much.
I was a picky kid,
like,
too.
Big one that you hated and now you love it?
Well, pork and beans used to make me gag, but now I eat them and I love them.
Okay.
Fish. Didn't like fish at all.
I'll say this. I hated broccoli as a kid, but
most
now I
broccoli.
Really, really like broccoli. I mean, it's got to be cooked right. It's got to be a little al dente.
Yeah, just a touch, a little snap in there.
But when I go to like Ruby Tuesdays or what's that other place? The burger
Applebee's?
Place. A Red Robin.
Red Robin.
Red Robin. Robin. They've got some good broccoli.
Yeah.
You know how they have theme restaurants?
Yeah.
I was thinking of one the other. You know Black Tuesday? Is that when the market crashed?
You mean Ruby Tuesday?
No, Black Tuesday when the market crashed.
Yeah. During the Depression.
I think so, yeah.
Like Black Tuesdays is a restaurant.
Yeah.
It is, like people are like throwing themselves out the windows because they're like, what is it?
That sounds great.
Not that,
there's
but
a
like
a banker hanging himself.
Yeah. Like, just like the restaurant. Foods they had back then. Like bread. And potato soup with mostly water in it.
It sounds horrible.
Yeah, it does sound
really
bad.
Welcome to Black Tuesdays!
That sounds way...
World's
he's got to be way more depressed.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Welcome to Black Tuesdays.
Well, it's still America.
Yeah, it's still America. What are you
doing
there?
Once you get depressed, you talk in that accent.
You don't.
I avoided sweet potatoes my whole life. And
that was
now
a mistake.
I love them so much.
Yeah, they're good. They're me good. Too.
I like them more than regular potatoes.
All right, let's move on.
To burps. Longest burp ever recorded.
Any
okay.
guesses?
Yeah.
Do you have the answer already?
I do.
A minute, 29 seconds.
Minute 52.
Are these overestimating?
Well, I'll just go ahead because I got 1 minute and 13 seconds.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, that was a good guess.
Cleared
there,
a minute.
Pick.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, it was in Italy. The Italians.
Probably
had some
ricotta.
In 2009. The loudest.
Yeah, sucking down on that ricotta.
Loudest was 109.9 decibels. In the UK in 2009. It was a good year for burps in 2009.
What's that comparable to? If, like, no one knows
louder
what that
than
means.
The roar of a motorcycle or chainsaw.
Whoa. That's
had to hurt.
I feel like... Yeah, that would, like, rupture your Adam's apple or something. Yeah, just crack it open like an egg.
Every year, cows in the USA burp about 50 million tons of gas into the atmosphere, majorly contributing to the greenhouse effect. The burps of 10 cows could heat a small house for a year.
Well, we should utilize that.
Yeah.
We need to send our cow burps to Alaska.
I desperately want to get off the grid.
We figured it out. Simon's a chicken. Chickens can't burp.
It's really? Me. I was a chicken in another life.
Now, Simon,
yeah.
You mentioned that you want to get off the grid.
Yeah.
We saw a movie on the plane. I think all of us watched it.
Yeah.
Captain Fantastic.
Captain Fantastic.
So good.
Yeah.
So good.
Really good
and
film.
Yeah. about a guy who had his kids and they were all living off the grid.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent movie.
So good.
Yeah, it was. Simon and I were like, what's this movie that Abster is watching? And Thick's like, oh, that's Captain Fantastic. It's a drama. It's about a family that loses their mother. And Abster is over there laughing his butt off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the whole plane's turning like, what's this guy laughing at?
Yeah.
It is a drama.
Oh, it is.
It is.
I was right. Yeah. And I'm waiting for
you're
those
like, oh,
laughs,
here's another Thick fact. And then I pulled it up on the damn screen.
No, it certainly is a drama, but it's one of those dramas that works really well because it has very good comedic moments. Yeah. At least I thought so.
I watched it. I didn't laugh, but I'm like, okay, that's a moment that Abster.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, quality film, man. One of the best I've seen in a long time.
Like, that's kind of what blew my mind. It's like such a good movie. Flew under everyone's radar, I guess.
Another fun movie that was short and just worth a watch.
Oh, Elvis meets Nixon.
Yeah, that was a great film.
I gotta watch that.
That was interesting.
Michael Shannon as Elvis, who doesn't look...
No, he didn't look like Elvis at all.
Yeah, it's like he doesn't look handsome. I think Michael Shannon's a very ugly man.
Yeah.
Who's Michael Shannon?
He's such a good damn actor.
He's the guy that played Elvis.
Zod.
Yeah, he was Zod in that shitty Superman film.
Oh, Zod, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, what else? I think we all watched Star Trek at the same time.
I saw it in the theater, so.
Yeah, I did not enjoy that.
Really?
I thought it was fine.
Yeah, it was.
I just expected it to be better.
So we've gone into our movie review.
What would you have done better? How would you make that movie better?
Made it good.
Less cheesy.
Put some pasta in it.
Which part was cheesy?
I tell you.
Most of the movie was cheesy.
When they had a chance to fucking, they could have like shot that bad guy, but let him talk.
Yeah let him monologue for a little bit.
What the fuck, man? Oh. Why do writers still even accept that?
Because audiences will accept that.
Ugh. Yeah. That is a Star Trek movie based on a very old franchise.
True.
It's probably used that trope a million times, and that's what their audience likes. I'll say this.
I purchased my Rogue One tickets yesterday.
Ooh.
I'm excited about the Rogue One.
Star Wars.
Yeah. You're excited about all things Star Wars.
Yeah, I am. I mean, that was my childhood. So.
Yeah, it looks cool.
Yeah.
I'm a little weary because it's a prequel, and all the other prequels were so good.
But there's no Jar Jar that we know of.
Yeah, I was about to say, you don't know that.
A little baby Jar Jar.
Mm-hmm.
It would just pop up. Yeah, like his kid, like...
Oh, right.
Ooh, we should need to steal the Death Star plans.
It's true.
Yes, sir! Wah-wah-wah!
It's gonna happen. Middle of the fucking film.
Yep, that'll be it. I'm wondering if they're going to tie the heroine to that. I forget. Jyn is her name, maybe?
Yeah.
If they're going to tie her to...
Aniston?
Jyn Aniston, yeah. If they're going to tie her to Rey from...
Rummy?
The Force Awakens.
Ray Romano?
Ray Romano. Yeah, Ray Romano in the Force Awakens.
Oh, Mom! I got this lightsaber. I don't know. Just put it up with the... With the coffee cups.
Raymond.
With the coffee cups.
He's got a lightsaber next to his coffee cups because he doesn't know what to do with it.
Can we make that cartoon? Everybody loves Raymond Star Wars mash.
Yeah.
I'll do a review.
I'll do
one of those crazy-eyed reviews like I did on The Force Awakens where I got all nuts.
Yeah, you did not like that one.
I do and I don't just because it's just recycled.
How many times have you seen it?
Probably about 4 times now.
Yeah. Really?
You really hate it, huh?
You keep on going. That's interesting.
Yeah, it's like when the song Love Shack comes on. I hate that fucking song, but I can't turn the radio. It's like, I'll just get to the end.
I can
turn
it.
One of your biggest complaints of that movie, I remember doing the review, was that it was the Death Star again.
Yeah.
And then immediately seeing the trailer for Rogue One, they're doing the Death Star again. It's like the biggest thing in the movie. It's like, we got to get the Death Star plan.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds shitty.
But it's about the people that got those plans.
You're right. I wonder if they get them or not.
Yeah, you know what you think. You know what's going to happen.
I'm on the edge of my seat the whole time wondering if they get the Death Star plans or not.
Damn.
But how? How did they do it?
How?
I don't know.
And what's the connection with all these people
to the other
characters? Yeah.
Ordered them online.
Yeah, came in the mail.
Yeah.
Here's those Death Star plans you ordered.
Oh, thing.
Yeah, and Ray Romano's in that one.
I don't know what to do with these plants. Just put it by the coffee cups.
Misa burped.
Simon, I'm glad you can make it out to the podcast.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah,
this has been fun.
This has been fun. So, what should we do now? We should just end it.
Yeah.
Say goodbye to everybody.
I feel like our end should be lackluster.